If you ask the recipients of today's awards, they'll say they're no heroes. But there are a lot of people here in Manchester this morning that would disagree.
She was an answer to prayer.
Steve Travis was fly fishing last October in Barrington when his boat capsized. Weighted down by his waders and tangled in fishing line, he was in trouble.
I had quite a discussion with God up there, I'm telling you. She came at the right time because I was pretty well spent.
It was just go, swim, yep, just dropped all my stuff and dove in.
Their story was one of five highlighted at the Red Cross Heroes Breakfast.
It gives us an opportunity to really honor unsung heroes, people who do extraordinary things every day to help New Hampshire residents.
People like Christopher Bridge, who for the past 13 years has been donating platelets.
You know, I have them and I can give them, and I give freely for that reason. You know, I know there's people out there that need it, and it's part of a community involvement, really.
It was August 22nd when Sharon Robichaud and her daughter were involved in a serious car accident.
I couldn't talk, I couldn't breathe. I didn't know at the time I had four broken ribs.
Fortunately for them, Robin Comstock was driving by at the time.
I was an international flight attendant for 11 years and received extensive training in first aid and first responder.
And that day, the training kicked in. Also recognized the Waterville Valley summer training staff that saved a camper that had gone into cardiac arrest, and Fox Company, 169th of the New Hampshire National Guard, for performing hundreds of life-saving missions in Afghanistan and being the first air crews to provide blood transfusions in flight, referred to as Operation Vampire. The governor says while the stories are different, they all have one thing in common. These are people who saw someone in need and rushed to help. In Manchester, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.